Here's a trick you can do with your students. Select one number in the grid. Now cross out all the other numbers in the same row and column. You should now have 9 numbers remaining. Pick one of the remaining numbers and circle it. Cross out all the other numbers in the same row and column as the second number you just picked. Now select one of the remaining 4 numbers and circle it. Cross out the other numbers in the same row and column, and you'll have 1 number left. Circle that number. Now add the 4 numbers that you have. Every time that students perform this trick, they'll get the same answer no matter what numbers they choose. They will always get a result of 42. So why does this work? Well, it all has to do with how the grid was created. The 16 numbers that occur in this grid are part of an addition table. That may not be obvious the way it's currently shown, but let me put the numbers in at the top of each column and at the side of each row to help. With those numbers in place, you can now see how each number in the grid was formed. 9, for instance, is the sum of 5 and 4. 11 is the sum of 9 and 2. 6 plus 8 makes the 14 that occurs there. So whenever a student chooses each number in a row and column, they get the number from the top and the number from the side as part of their final sum. For instance, if a student chooses 17 and crosses out all other numbers from that column and that row, well, the 17 was formed from the 8 and the 9. When the student chooses another number, they now get the numbers from that column and that row, and so on. Consequently, the 4 numbers in the grid that were chosen are going to be equal to the sum of the 4 numbers along the top and the 4 numbers along the side. In every case, that gives a sum of 42. The nice thing about this trick is that students can personalize it so that the result is whatever number they want. For instance, perhaps a student likes the number 37. Then that student could choose numbers along the top and the side that have a sum of 37. For instance, if they put 2, 5, 8, 7, 4, 2, 6, 3, the sum of those 8 numbers is 37, and the result of the trick will always be 37. Simply fill in the grid with the sum of the numbers. The student can then use this grid, without the numbers along the top or the side, to personalize the trick for their own use. In the classroom, you can add drama to this trick by having the number revealed on your arm as was done in the beginning of this video. The way to do this is to use a toothpick and actually spread rubber cement on your arm. It should be known that this is non-toxic and won't hurt. And paint the number that's going to come up at the end of your trick with the rubber cement. You can do this ahead of time, before students arrive to class. Give adequate time for the rubber cement to dry. Just before class starts, as students are about to enter, rub your finger in an ample amount of eyeshadow. Then, when students complete the trick, say, "The number is revealed," and rub the eyeshadow across the rubber cement for the number to show up.